Good morning, Honorable Head of School, distinguished teachers, esteemed staff, community, and my fellow students. Today is no ordinary morning. It's with great joy and excitement that I stand before you today to welcome you all to Gigi's Whimsical Wednesday. As the name suggests, it's all about bringing a touch of magic and fun to our mornings, making our school life into something truly special. It's an invitation for us to think more deeply, celebrate with joy, and come together as a stronger, more connected community. I have no doubt that these new mornings will inspire us and make our school life even more delightful. Now, as we dive into the excitement of the day, this week holds something extra special. Do we know why? Yes, go on, Yunshan. Sorry?
Because it's the whimsical Wednesday.
Oh, that's not right, my friend, I'm afraid. Syra?
Madras week.
That's right, my friend. Yes, it's Madras week. Tomorrow marks the birthday of our incredible city. This is our time to celebrate everything we love about our beloved city, its rich culture, fascinating history, and all the things that make Chennai feel like home. Get ready for a thrilling ride filled with excitement, surprises, and joy. Let's come together to make this whimsical Wednesday and the rest of Madras week a truly unforgettable experience. Thank you, and over to Shanvi.
As we embark on this thrilling whimsical Wednesday, let us unite in spirit and pride. Please stand together with us as we proudly sing our school anthem, a heartfelt melody that echoes the values we cherish and the bond we share as a school community. Let the lyrics remind us of our resilience, collective strength, and the unbreakable spirit that makes our school shine. So what are we waiting for? Let's get started.
Oh, Galloping Gazelles are proud to present an enthralling skit that takes you on a vibrant journey through the very heart of Madras. From its rich heritage to its bustling streets, we bring you the very soul of the city in just a few moments.
बोल नहीं
इंग्लिश बोल
वी नीड टू गो टू गिंडी फॉरेस्ट कैन यू हेल्प अस
श्योर
ये कितना गरम है
व्हाई इज इट सो हॉट हियर
चेन्नई हॉट आ रखूं बट सिंस वी आर अ कोस्टल सिटी वी हैव अ लॉट ऑफ ब्रीज
वी हैव ब्यूटीफुल बीचेस इन चेन्नई डू यू हैव बीचेस इन द नॉर्थ
नो वी डोंट कैन यू टेक अस
श्योर We'll take you around in an auto.
What's a auto?
It's auto, not auto. Like you have rickshaws in North India, we have autos in the southern part of India. And it's one of the most popular vehicles here.
This is the central station.
The official name of the station was Porachi Thalaivar Dr. M.G. Ramachandran. It is also one of the most busiest and most important railway station in the whole of India.
It was built in 1873, around 150 years ago.
In 1907, the station was made the main station of the Chennai Railway Company. The station's position was strengthened after the construction of headquarters of the Madras and Southern Maratha Railway, which is adjacent to it.
Approximately 6 lakh people travel by that station every single day, which means at least 200 trains come and go by.
Additionally, the station is fully integrated with the Chennai Metro, offering easy access to go to the various parts of the city.
The trains in the station can travel to the subway, suburban parts of Chennai, and all of northern India.
Also, did you know the station's name is the longest in India and the second longest in the world?
The waiting area can accommodate over 1,000 people. There are 17 platforms in the station, out of which 5 travel to the suburban parts of India.
Thank you.
Let's move on to the next place. This is Fort St. George. It's a very famous fort in Chennai.
Fort St. George was built in 1639 and was the first British fortress in India. It was named in honor of Britain patron saint and it was finished on 23rd of April 1644. The main aim behind this was trade and economic activities as it was near the sea. It served as a home for the officials of the East India Company and helped in the development of Madras.
I'm going to be talking about the beauty of Fort St. George. It is 6 meters high and which is 20 feet tall. It's made of gray granite walls at the exterior. It has flag which is 150 feet tall. Side of Fort St. George, there's a statue of Lord Culloden. Thank you.
Let's move on to the next place.
This is the Marina Beach, one of the most famous beaches in Chennai.
Oh wow, it looks so beautiful.
Now we are at the famous lighthouse.
I want to see all the lights in here.
There's only one big light here.
The Marina Beach.
Beach is the second longest beach in the world and the longest in India. It stretches from Fort St. George in the north and ends in Basudhagar in the south. It's India's one most crowded beach. In 1884, the beach was first named Madras Marina by Governor Sir Duff. Along the public pathway, there are around 17 statues of the leaders of the country. According to the records, at least 5,000 people come for morning rounds. A few noticeable landmarks near the Marina Beach are is the lighthouse and the Napier Bridge. Thank you.
The Marina Lighthouse is tall and important building located on Marina Beach, Chennai, Tamil Nadu. It is one of the city's most famous landmarks. It stands about 46 meters high and helps ships safely get inside the harbor. Here are some interesting facts about the Marina Lighthouse. The Marina Lighthouse uses a powerful light to help sailors and captains where the coast is, especially at night or during bad weather. History: built in 1976, making it the modern lighthouse. Observation deck: you can visit the lighthouse and climb up to the observation deck to get a beautiful view of Chennai and the ocean. Red and white stripes, which make it stand against the blue sky and the blue oceans.
Thank you.
Now let's move on to the next place.
This is the Santam Church, a very popular church in Chennai.
Santam Church is one of the most famous churches in the whole world. It was built by a group of Portuguese explorers during the year 1893 and to 1896. It is one of the only three churches built above a tomb of an apostle. The other ones are in Spain and Italy.
It has tall towers and large open space inside. People come to visit where St. Thomas is said to be buried.
Let's move on to the next place.
This is the Walaja Mosque. It's a very important mosque in Chennai.
The big mosque, or the Walaja Mosque, was built in 1795.
It's built by the family of Muhammad Ali Khan, the royal family of Arakot.
The Walaja Mosque was made of granite and without iron or wood.
Most of the staffs are Hindus, symbolizing peace to other religions.
The Walaja Mosque has a big prayer hall.
It's also known as Big Mosque.
The entire Walaja Mosque is the most prettiest in entire South India.
Thank you.
Let's move on to our next place.
This is Mylapur Temple, a very important temple in Chennai.
Did you know that the Gopuram in the Kabaleeswara Temple was built in the 1906? And it's over 120 feet long, and it's still standing today.
The type of architecture used to build the Kapaleeswar Temple is called Dravidian style of architecture, which includes gopurams like the ones you might see in around the Taj Mahal and elaborate sculptures.
There are lots of legends for the Kapaleeswara Temple, but one of them is that Lord Shiva cut off one of Lord Brahma's heads, and it fell down into earth, and it made a temple.
Another legend features Lord Shiva and Goddess Parvati. It is that Lord Shiva was explaining something to Goddess Parvati, but then Goddess Parvati got distracted by a dancing peon, and Lord Shiva got angry and turned Goddess Parvati into the form of a dancing peon and sent her down to earth.
The temple was mainly built to worship Lord Shiva.
An interesting fact about the temple is that it's the only temple dedicated to Lord Shiva without any Nandi waiting in front.
Some people believe that Lord Shiva was born in the Mylapur.
The temple was built by ruling Pallavas.
The Kabaleeswara temple is also known as one of Chennai's oldest temples, which makes it so famous that at least 30,000 people visit a day.
The temple has a tank, and that tank lies towards the west of the main temple.
There's a lake in the temple which people take holy dips in to signify new life.
This temple was built in 7th century CE.
So this temple was built in the 7th century, but the Portuguese destroyed it, so they had to remake it in the 16th century. Some of the sculptures are man-made and some of them are natural, which means it's engraved into the soil by itself, and it's so humans just give it a little bit of touch-ups.
Oh wow, that was so interesting to hear about.
Let's move on to the next place. This is the Marmalong Bridge. It is a very old bridge.
Why is this half broken?
Let's hear more about it.
The Maraimalai Adigal Bridge, previously known as the Marmalong Bridge, is a road bridge in Annai Salai. It is used to connect the southern and the northern banks of the Adyar River. It is built by the Armenian merchant Kodarji Petras Uskon. It is built in 1726 to 28. It cost over 1 lakh rupees. Here's a fact. Some people actually tried to break down the bridge, but they failed. This shows that the construction was very strong. This is also the oldest bridge across the Adyar River, and we are very happy to have such a beautiful bridge in our Chennai.
Let's move on to the second last place of this trip. This is the Jam Bazaar. It is very busy as many people come here to do shopping.
Jam Bazaar is a heritage market that was set up in the pre-independence era. It is located in the Triplicane and is home to both Hindu and Muslim communities. It is historically and socially important. Jam Bazaar now holds more than 800 shops selling vegetables, meat, fish, rice, and banana leaves. The whiff of spices, the chaos of bargaining, and the wide range of colorful things is no different for Jam Bazaar in Chennai. Thank you.
Let's move on to the last place of this trip.
This is the Gindi Forest. Is this your destination?
Yes, this is our destination.
Thank you very much.
The smallest park in India. It is located in Chennai, Tamil Nadu. It is spread over 2.7 kilometers, hence is the smallest park. This is a home to many animals like black bug, jackal, spotted deer, and butterflies, vertebrates and non-vertebrates. The Gindi Park is an interesting park, so all of us should visit there.
Gindi is an evergreen forest. William Langholm built Gindi. Gindi was established in 1977 and the river Adyar flows through Gindi. Gindi was originally a game reserve and it was recently renovated. In 2006, there were 750 lakh visitors. Gindi is around 650 acres. There are no cats in Gindi. Gindi's old name was Brinji Malay, but now they have changed it to Gindi. Thank you.
That was a spectacular skit. Thank you, actors, directors, and everyone behind the scenes for bringing the vibrant spirit of Chennai to life with such creativity and energy. So let's give a big round of applause to everyone involved.
Now is the time to call on two students and one teacher who have made our school proud. We invite Shreya from GG, Isha from SS, and Sangeeta Aunty. Shreya from GG participated in South Zone Taekwondo Championship, which was held in Bangalore. She won 2 silver medals, one for sparring and one for patterns.
Shreya, I would like to ask you how you prepared for South Zone Taekwondo Championship and what challenges did you face while doing sparring and patterns?
I prepared the championship by practicing twice a week in my class and practicing at home in patterns and sparring. The challenges I've mainly faced was that some people were taller than me in sparring. And yeah.
Isha from SS participated in Virtuosa, a piano competition which was conducted by Chriswood School. She came in second place. Isha, I would like to ask you, what piece did you perform at Chriswood School and how did you feel when you announced the second place?
I performed 2 pieces, 1 compulsory piece and 1 piece that I chose. I only had 1 month to prepare both pieces, which is not that much time, especially as they were quite hard. So I didn't play as well as I hoped I would play, and I felt extremely happy when I secured second place. I was also very surprised, and next year I'm aiming for first.
Sangeeta Aunty finished her Jolly Phonics successfully. Sangeeta Aunty, why do you think learning phonics is important for us and how do you plan on teaching us?
Good morning, everyone. So, recently I did my Jolly Phonics. It was rather a brush up, training, and also the Jolly Grammar. So, I first want to ask you that if I ask you to spell mat, how do you want to spell it? M-A-T, right? But the early learners who are in the kindergarten, they learn it by sound. Once you get the sound, then you are easily, it's called the science of reading, okay? It's not merely you are mugging up a spelling and putting it in your paper. So Jolly Phonics is important to have that kind of phonological awareness. These are the big terms, but the sound, everything is about sound, right? So when we say cat or mat for the kindergarten, they say k, ah, cat, cat. This is the way they decode, and also encoding comes. There are many ways. So this is very important to give you the strong literacy skill in your early years. And it is absolutely applicable for the 3 to 7 years, and the Jolly Grammars come for the early primary section. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Shreya, Isha, and Sangeeta Aunty. We are very proud of you.
Well done. Congratulations. Thank you, Sangeeta Aunty.
Stay with us, because coming up next, we've got the top headlines you need to know on the Weekly Herald. We bring you the latest updates on the stories that are shaping your world today. All that and more in a jiffy.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Anjali, and this is the Global News. U.S. President Joe Biden delivers final Democratic National Congress speech and gets a rousing ovation from Democrats as he endorses Kamala Harris. Japan's governing Liberal Democratic Party is set to elect its new leader and the country's next prime minister after Prime Minister Fumio Kishida's sudden decision to resign. Thank you.
I'm Siddharth, and I'm going to be reporting about the national news. Ties with Russia, Ukraine stands on their own. Mr. Modi will visit Poland on August 21st and 22nd, and Ukraine on August 23rd. This will be the first visit by an Indian prime minister in 45 years to Poland, and the first to Ukraine in 30 years. Thank you.
Good morning, I'm Kiara, presenting Chennai News. The Highways Department has set a fresh deadline to complete the work to widen ECR from Thiruvanmiyur to Uttandi. On approval, it would be completed within 18 months.
Thank you.
My name is Ajitesh, and I will be reporting the sports news. Aman Sehrawat, an Indian boxer, got a
got a bronze in 57 kg boxing in the 2024 Paris Olympics. He won it just before he turned 21 on August 9, 2024. This makes him the youngest Indian Olympic medalist. He commandingly won 13-5 against Puerto Rico's Darian Cruz. Thank you.
I'm Gianna with the latest Casey High News. Gigi's took a trip to Kareni Native Farms on Monday. Grade 10 will be heading to Ovule in Pondicherry for a field trip this Friday. Mr. Shivashankar Babu from the Tamil Heritage Trust will be visiting our school today as a guest speaker for Madras Week celebration. Thank you.
My name is June. I'm going to share about the weather. Heavy to very heavy rainfall, very likely at isolated places over Uttarakhand, Sikkim, Tamil Nadu, and Kerala. Tonight, temperature range is 35.0 degrees Celsius and the minimum is 29.1 degrees Celsius. Thank you.
As we wrap up today's assembly, I would like to take a moment to thank our Gigi teachers for their invaluable support. Thank you, aunties. Now, let us all remember to give our best and stand proud, for every single moment is a chance to shine. On that note, thank you for being here and good day. Now, please rise and face the national flag as we honor our nation with the national anthem. The moment to pause, reflect and renew and keep these wise words in your head for the rest of the day. The thought for the day will be presented by Ashrika from Gigi.
Good morning, I am Ashrika, sharing the thought for the day, which is for you to ponder upon. I am going to say a Thirukkural and the meaning of the Thirukkural in English. தொட்டனை தூரும் மணற்கேணி மாந்திற்கு கட்டனை தூரும் அறிவு. Meaning, if you dig the land more, you will get more water. As same as, if you learn more, you will get more wisdom. Nandri and thank you.
Children, let's give a round of applause for Jagananna, Paul sir, Jonathan sir, facilities team, Vyas, who's played for us today, and last but not the least, Selvin sir with Madhi Anna. Thank you, children. Thank you, Gigi teachers.